Get ready, wrestling fans, for the most exciting hour on television with the Continental Wrestling Federation. This week, we'll see action from the Southern Boys, Brickhouse Brown, the Stud Stable, the Lethal Weapon Dennis Condrey, and lots more. Right now, let's go ringside with our host, Charlie Platt.
Hello, everybody. Welcome once again to the Continental Wrestling Federation. Charlie Platt along with Johnny Rich from the Montgomery Civic Center. And there are a lot of big things happening around the CWF. We've got some eight-man cage matches, still some Thunderdomes going on, battle royals. But the big news is what?
A lot of money being passed out in the CWF.
And for the ladies, a very special event coming up.
A beautiful mink coat, Charlie, 17 to be exact, given away in the CWF area.
That's all over the CWF, all over the southeastern United States, and maybe in your local area. Of course, be watching for details, and before this program's over, we'll have some interesting details on the mink coat tournament coming to the CWF. Stay with us for the next hour. A lot of great wrestling action coming your way. Our television main event will put the CWF heavyweight champion, Dennis Condrey, against Brad Armstrong. What a matchup that is.
Yeah, good match to see, Charlie, right there.
Stay with us on the Continental Wrestling Federation. Let's go to the ring for our first match of the day. This event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing at 270 pounds, Mad Max. His partner at 231 from parts unknown, the Panther. Seven Boys, Tracy Smothers, and Steve Armstrong. One ball, 10-minute time limit on this one. Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong, the Southern Boys, going out against Mad Max and the Panther. Joining me at ringside, Dixie Dynamite.
All right. Charlie Platt, this is where it's at, brother. Right here with you.
This is the place. This is the address you've been looking for. Something I want to bring out briefly before we get into this match too far is your brother's. Oh, look at this. This match could be over in a hurry. Your brother's sideline career, your brotherly friend, Mr. Steve Armstrong.
He's a good friend of mine. Right?
Yeah,
you can
like
say
brothers.
What I almost like, brother.
That's
yeah.
What I heard. I believe he has still got a single career going. Is that right?
Oh, that's exactly right, brother. He's got that album on a roll tonight, rocking and rolling. I mean, look at this, bro. Have you ever seen a team so finely tuned in your career?
They, when Tracy and Steve came back from that last tour of Japan, Dixie, I made the comment, never have I seen two young athletes that have things more together than these wild-eyed Southern boys.
You see that right there? That's the Dixie Deflator. Knocked all the air out of him. How about that, Charlie?
Yeah. That.
Look at this.
Fired right by Steve Armstrong out again over in the corner.
Look at
that. Southern boys are on a roll tonight here at the Montgomery Civic Center.
That's right. You know my theme song, Dixie Dynamite, brother. Southern Stick of Power, Dixie
Dynamite. Good suplex by Steve Armstrong. And understand Steve has been contacted by many big country and rock promoters about appearances. Did you see that?
That's exactly right, Charlie. These boys are wanted in the ring, out of the ring, in the singing buildings. I'll tell you what, they got it going on right now. That Tracy Smothers, you know, he wrestled for Carson Newman College, the Atlantic Coast Conference. He was the number one wrestler. He got in there wrestling, playing linebacker for the football team. Whew!
What a clothesline by Steve Armstrong. And again, we see the well-oiled machine, finely tuned, as Dixie Dynamite said, of these Southern boys come to life against the Panther and Mad Max on this edition of the Continental Wrestling Federation. High in the air he goes, drop kick.
Lift his head off. I'll tell you what, Charlie Platt, you can look in any wrestling organization in the world and you won't see any two any better than these two boys right
that
here.
That should about do it for the Panther.
Oh, no, my boys ain't had enough yet, Charlie.
Yeah, coming up, we've got
practice makes perfect, and this is going to be it.
Woo!
That's it.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Great teamwork to those Southern boys.
Here we go. Don't
this,
you know?
This Panthers had about all one human being could take in one day.
That's exactly right. And about to get the final dose.
And I believe he
whoa!
There's enough firing him to know he's in the wrong position. It's over.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, yeah.
Your winners of the match, those wild-eyed Southern boys, Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong. And we'll talk with Tracy and Steve after you watch this on what's happening in your local arena.
Look out, Mobile. Here comes the Continental Wrestling Federation Thursday night, November 23rd at 7:30 in Fort Whiting Armory. Don't miss it. It's the Meat Coat Tournament for Mobile. In the first round, Dennis Condrey meets Brickhouse Brown. Robert Fuller with Sylvia takes on Jerry Stubbs. Jimmy Golden with Bruno takes on Steve Armstrong. Brian Lee meets Tracy Smothers. Mark the Beast Goulin with Sylvia takes on Adrian Street with Linda. Jack Manson with Bruno takes on Dixie Dynamite. And Ron Starr takes on Todd Morton. All that in the first round of the Meat Coat Tournament. 11 big matches. One lucky lady is walking out of Fort Whiting Armory with a brand new, beautiful, expensive Meat Coat. Absolutely free. All you got to do is pick the right wrestler. Thursday night, November 23rd at 7:30. It's the Continental Wrestling Federation in Mobile. Don't miss it.
I want to take a minute to talk to the Southern boys, Tracy Smothers, Steve Armstrong, and Dixie Dynamite. A lot of big events happening around the CWF. We've got these big eight-man cage matches going on. We have got, of course, the Thunderdome Battle Royals taking place. And the big news for the ladies, of course, the Mink Coat Tournament.
Oh, that's exactly right. And you know the Southern boys and Double D are involved in all three Mink Coat Tournaments. Cage match. You know what happens when they run out of matches where they can't keep them all in the ring? They put the cage around it all, and JR Promotions has done it again, brother. Meat coat tournaments, cages. It's all happening in the CWF.
In some cases recently, we've had problems not only keeping them in the ring, but keeping them in the building.
That's right. You know what? The stud stable's been after us for a long time. And, brother, the trail's is hotter than ever right now. We're on their trail. We want to get them out of this area is what we really want to do. After this cage match, after we kill them. Beat them up, bloody them up all over this arena. We want them in a lose-or-leave-town match after that and get rid of them for good.
Charlie, this is what it's all about, man. I feel really good today, baby. I feel great. Now, I'm going to tell you this, Stud Stable. We got an eight-man cage match coming up. Now, that's where it ends right there, pal, because when you get the cage around that ring, there's no getting in, there's no running, no peeping, no chucking, and no jiving. We fought you in every type of match conceivable to man, and a cage match is where it ends, pal, and I'll guarantee you this. As sure as the sun sets over here and rises over here, the Southern boys, Dixie D and Mr. Perfect Jerry Stubbs, are coming out on top. Now, to the lighter side of things, we're talking about meat coat tournaments, we're talking about pretty ladies, and we're talking about somebody that's going to want a pretty meat coat, and I doggone sure hope it's me, Steve, or Dixie, or Mr. Perfect that gets hand that pretty meat coat over to some lucky lady. So I'll guarantee you this, there's a lot of things happening in the CWF, Charlie, and the Southern boys and Dixie D are right in the middle of it. Like Lee said, guaranteed not to rust, bust, collect dust, bend, break, or splinter.
As well, that Southern boys along with Dixie Dynamite, a lot of action coming up on the CWF. Brickhouse Brown in action next. You stay with us. Producing at 255 pounds from parts unknown, the Gladiator. His opponent at 225 pounds from Florida, please welcome to the CWF Brickhouse Brown. Bell sounds, we're ready for action. Brickhouse Brown moves out against the Gladiator, and Brickhouse Brown, what a reputation this young athlete has built for himself all over the country. Quick clothesline by Brown on the Gladiator. Snapmare takedown, follows up. Oh, smashing down into the face of the Gladiator. Good. Elbow coming off the ropes from the state of Florida, known all over the country. He is quite an athlete. Hooks his man. suplex. Dropping down with the elbow. And again, dropping the elbow into the upper chest area. Brickhouse Brown exploding on the Gladiator on this edition of the Continental Wrestling Federation. We got six-man tag action coming up today. And as we said, our television main event puts the CWF heavyweight champion, Dennis Condrey, against Brad Armstrong on today's edition of the Continental Wrestling Federation. Ring official Larry Brock watching closely the Gladiator. Good reversal by Brown into the turnbuckle. Goes the Gladiator, high back body drop. And Brickhouse Brown right back in control of things. Headbutt by Brown puts the Gladiator down to the canvas. Reversal by the Gladiator now. Wait a minute, Brickhouse coming up. Beautiful, well-executed neckbreaker. Brickhouse Brown now climbing those ring ropes in the turnbuckle, flying off into the chest. It is over, and your winner of the match from the state of Florida is Brickhouse Brown. And if we could, we'd like to get Brickhouse Brown over for a word, if we could. I'd like to talk. If you don't mind, I'd like to talk.
This man, fantastic. I want to talk to this man, too. Get him down here.
You want to talk to him.
Yes, I want to talk to him.
Brickhouse Brown, we were hoping to get.
I'm saying you do, Charlie.
To have a conversation with Brickhouse Brown one-on-one, and but the mob has decided.
I want you to take this right here and fumble through it a little bit.
Money.
Go ahead. Have a look at that. I want to tell you something, Charlie Patterson. This man's a quality wrestler right here. How about it, Montgomery? Is this a quality wrestler right here? This is about the hardest stuff I've seen come down the bike. What I want you to do, finger through there and get some license out of there. I want you to take that wallet just like it is and take it on with you, Daddy. What I got?
I'm in this business for one thing, and that's to make some money. I'll be a fool to turn this down.
You'll be a fool if you take him up, I guarantee you that.
Let me tell you something. I'm not out here to ask your advice on anything. What I got here is I've got an informal contract, more or less like shaking hands. This is my man downtown, Bruno. Brickhouse Brown, I'd like to have you in my stable. I'd like you to be one of my men.
I got one thing. Do the credit cards go along with all this? Is everything in this one?
You better think this over. Hey.
Yes, sir.
Brickhouse, you better think this over a long time.
Just a minute. Let me do the talking. The credit cards and everything. Look at my driver's license. Hand me my driver's license out here. That's all I need, Daddy. The rest of it's yours. That's the way the Tennessee stud does business. That's the only way to do business. Let's go in the back right now. We'll sign up the contract. Charlie, I got me a new man in my stable.
Well, I tell you what. I hate to see that. I'm sure he'll probably learn a lesson the hard way by dealing with Robert Fuller, no doubt about that.
Welcome to a special personality profile on one of the most exciting, if not the exciting, event of the year in the Continental Wrestling Federation. Tracy Smothers of the Southern Boys is with me. And Tracy, the Mink Coat Tournament is right around the corner. And to better educate the ladies as to how a Mink Coat Tournament operates in the CWF, we thought we'd kind of walk them through the paces, if you will. The Mink Coat Tournament actually begins right outside the ticket office.
Oh, yeah, it starts right here, Charlie. They come right through the door right here, pay their ticket. They come in, they get a piece of paper, and they sign their name on it, and they put it in their favorite wrestler's box right here. And by the way, ma'am, right here what we're talking
about. Wait a minute,
about.
It doesn't necessarily have to be the favorite wrestler, Tracy. It could be the one they think will win.
Well, I'll tell you this, ma'am, my name's Tracy Smothers.
All right. And your name is?
Kim.
Kim? You looking forward to the big Mink Coat tournaments?
Sure.
It's going to be all over the CWF. And like we say, who do you think will win the tournament is who the lady puts that little slip of paper with her name in the box. All right?
All right.
And show us how we would go about doing this. We have three choices out here to give this illustration. Of course, Tracy Smothers, Dixie Dynamite, and Steve Armstrong's box.
Steve Armstrong.
Okay, Steve, I think Charlie and Tracy covered that first segment real good. Now, if we can explain the second part of this thing here, After the boxes come from the front, after you've come in and put your name in the box, then all the boxes come down here to the ringside. And then what happens?
Okay, at that point, the wrestler, each individually, will take his box, and pull a name out of it. The name we'll pull out, we'll say, just as an example right now, is Miss Kim Peavy.
Okay, Miss Kim Peavy. Miss Kim would come on down, and Steve would put a ribbon. Okay, Steve, there you go.
Wait a minute, Dixie Dynamite, yeah. That ain't mine.
Okay, Dixie Dynamite, we're going to go ahead and explain the final step as to how you win the mink coat.
Well, the final step, as you can see, this pretty lady, naturally at the beginning of all this, put her name in Dixie Dynamite's box, and here she is. If I was fortunate enough to have wrestled 3 or 4 matches and won that tournament, then I'd have that warm-hearted pleasure, and believe me, look at this pretty lady. It'd definitely be a pleasure to wrap a mink coat around this Southern Belle. And, brother, I'd love nothing better than maybe give her a nice warm hug. Woo! The excitement's building already for all these mink coat tournaments. But the bottom line is, I understand Mr. Continental's done ordered up 17 mink coats to go in 17 Southern cities for the mink coat tournament. So somewhere in the South, there's going to be 17 pretty ladies wrapped up in minks for the holidays. And I'm looking forward to being a part of it. Thank you.
This is the greatest country music star of all time. In music circles, he's known as the legend.
If you only love me half as much as I love you.
His timeless hits like this are recording classics.
I'm so long,
now here are the timeless hits of the legend, Hank Williams.
Oh, like you, he never got him.
Hank Williams made country music irresistible to millions. Everyone's a classic. This record was number one for 42 weeks. You get the famous love songs. All these timeless classics are in this album, but you also get Hank Williams' most heart-touching songs of all. No one else can sing the Hank Williams songs like he can.
And melt your cold, cold heart.
They're all yours. You'll love every classic in this beautiful treasury. But remember, you also get Treasury Number 1. You get them both. They've never been offered before, and they're not in any store. Order yours now.
Use your MasterCard, Visa, Diners Club, or American Express. Call toll-free 1-800-252-0900. 1-800-252-0900. You get 2 records, 2 cassettes, or 2 8-track tapes. To save handling and COD charges, send only $12.98 to Hank Williams. CWF Wrestling, Box 250045, Montgomery, Alabama, 36125. Or call now, 1-800-252-0900.
Ladies and gentlemen, this 6-man tag event schedule 1 fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing from Hawaii, Dean Ho. From Knoxville, Tennessee, Daryl Hall. And from North Carolina, Chief Little Lynn. Their opponents, the Stud Stable, Robert Fuller, Cactus Jack Madsen, and Primetime Brian Lee.
I know you're just very happy to have me here beside you. And for you uninformed ignoramuses out there in Alabama and Florida, this is the voice of the CWF Junior Heavyweight Champion, the Sun-Up Cruiser himself, Downtown Bruno.
Yeah,
what do you think about that, Charlie, the Sun-Up Cruiser? I'm happy
all,
to be here.
If everyone at home could wait till the count of three, let's all get together and laugh together.
Junior, are they showing a close-up of you, Charlie? Is that
Junior, wait a minute. What's Stubbs doing out here?
All right. Six-man tag action about to get underway, but it seems we have what appears to be
last-minute
substitution in this match.
You got it.
Last-minute substitution in this match.
We should have met Brody. We didn't say nothing about no Jerry Stubbs. What's the deal?
And here he comes. Hard like a prime time.
Hey. What's
now he's
fish?
On Jack Manson. Wait a minute. This is a...
Please,
he's warning Robert Fuller, and he'll stop at no length, it appears, to get his hands on one Robert Fuller. The Tennessee stud has made Jerry Stubbs very, very angry in recent weeks. And it's no secret. He wants him one-on-one.
Charlie, we signed for a match with three jabronis, Tom, Dick, and Harry Nobody. Nobody said nothing about old Jerry Stubbs, Mr. Imperfect. We could beat him 8 days a week, 14 times on Sunday, so we weren't prepared for him. The stable wasn't trained for Stubbs today, and I don't think it's fair that he can just come barging in this match and send that no-account nobody back to the dressing room. And I don't like it one bit, Charlie. What do you think? You probably love it, don't you?
I think it's great. I really do. Yeah, you're right. Cactus Jack Manson moving out against Jerry Stubbs, who at the last minute joined this little get-together here. The Montgomery Civic Center tag is made with Dean Hull. And he clamps down with the pressure. Good move by Manson.
Dean Hull. Really comes from a whole long line of hoes. Don Ho. Well, you got no comment to make about that, Charlie? How'd you? What's this here sitting in front of you? You've been talking about some muscle man or something. What's the deal here?
Well, the deal is, if it's any of your business, which I don't think anything is your business, besides breathing precious air that others should have. Well, next week on the program, we'll have Tom Owen, founder and director of the King's Ranch for boys and girls throughout the state of Alabama. And Tom has a campaign going now where they're selling for the holiday seasons, and maybe you've seen the displays in grocery stores. You'll find popcorn grown by the kids at the King's Ranch. And it's a very great fundraiser for the King's Ranch. And you'll see the displays, Tom Owens and kids from the King's Ranch throughout the state of Alabama. And we have a...
Hey.
Well, Jerry Stubbs has cleaned the ring. He has cleaned the ring. There's Sylvia with that stick. Continues to pound away Stubbs. Well, the chair is bigger than Bruno, but he has it in his hand. This thing is really getting out of hand in the early stage of this six-man. As I was saying, maybe you've seen the displays and for King's Ranch Gold Popcorn and Food World throughout Alabama, Northwest Florida, and in some Bruno stores.
In some what?
And we'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take a break right now, and we'll be back with the conclusion of this match in a matter of moments. All right, back to the action here in the Montgomery Civic Center. Dean Ho. Oh, boy. Double clothesline by primetime Brian Lee and Jack Manson. Jerry Stubbs, as we said, kind of a late entry in this match. Two count, and he brings him up. Obviously, they want to try to punish their man here.
Charlie, may I say something?
I guess so.
I heard you say something about Bruno's. Now, I think the King's Ranch is a great cause, and I think everybody should support it. But I didn't know nothing about me selling popcorn out of my house now. I mean, ain't nobody consulted me about it.
Certainly, you don't want to buy popcorn from downtown Bruno, but I buy it at a Bruno store. That's the only sensible thing.
Wait a minute now.
Look at this. Chief Little and all, he
had things going. Whoa! Did you see that devastating move?
From I think that's
Texas.
The most devastating thing I've ever seen.
Vince and I have never, never seen anything like that. They roll him back in the ring. And I tell you what a move. This guy has no respect for an opponent, and obviously he has no respect for his own well-being with that kind of move, you know.
Let's just say this. He might be a few bricks shy of a low, but maybe that's what we like about him, Charlie.
Well,
maybe that's why the stable likes him. Hey, by the way, we've got a lot of big things coming up. We're talking about 8 men in the steel cage.
Oh.
We're talking about mink coat tournaments. We're talking about Brickhouse Brown. We're talking about victory in every one of those contests to the stud stable. And we're talking about Brickhouse Brown, our newest fine. And I'm very, very happy and quite proud to have Brickhouse Brown as part of this
Robert
stable.
Fuller in.
I tell you, it's time to ring the bell.
Robert
the party's
really
over.
That one. But,
hey, Charlie, that's the way it has to be, because that's the way I like it.
Okay, well, there you have the comments of the one and only Downtown Bruno. We're going to talk to the stud stable in a matter of moments. Right now, let's take a look at what's happening in your local arena.
The Continental Wrestling Federation is on tour and coming to your area with all the big names, big stars, and big wrestlers. Look out, Foley, Alabama. Wednesday night, November 15th is your night, 7:30, and the National Guard Armory. Don't miss it. Crestview, Florida will never leave you out. Thursday night, November 16th at 7:30 in the National Guard Armory and in Pensacola. Sunday night, November 19th at 7:30 in the National Guard Armory. Pensacola, you get the $5,000 Thunderdome Battle Royal. Don't miss it. Plus, a Continental Tag Match as Jimmy Golden and Brian Lee take on the Southern Boys, Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong. And for the Continental title, Loverboy Dennis Condrey meets Brad Armstrong in a battle for the belt. And in a special challenge match, Robert Fuller with Sylvia meets Jerry Stubbs to try to settle that difference. And lots more in Pensacola, Sunday night, November 19th at 7:30 in the National Guard Armory. Don't miss the excitement of a CWF.
Well, we're here with the stud stable who has a lot of things that they'll be facing in the upcoming weeks here in the CWF, one of which will be 8-man cage matches.
Yeah, you know, it seems that those boys, those Southern boys I'm talking about, and their good buddy Jerry Stubbs and Dixie Dynamite just can't get enough of a bruising. It seems like they go around begging and aching for a bruising. So I'm going to tell you something, boys. We're going to give you a little bit more of a bruising. You're going to get inside that cage with the likes of the stud stable. Cousin Brian, am I bad or what, Daddy?
The baddest, Charlie, the baddest.
And I'm going to tell you something, boys. You ain't got a chance in heck. Now let me tell you what fires me up. It's me, Coach Tenement, that fires me up. But what fires me up is not giving it to one of you good-for-nothing Alabama nothings out here. Charlie, I want to know right now why Sylvia has been kicked out of that Mink Coat tournament. Why is she not going to be eligible for that Mink Coat?
Well, I think the reasons are obvious.
Well, I'm going to tell you something. Every one of the guys right here, every one of them, and you might as well take it right now and smoke it in your pipe, every one of them are caliber to win a Mink Coat for any ugly, good-for-nothing Alabama mama sitting out here,
Charlie,
in the crowd.
And from what I see, you better get a lot of extra-large jackets for these ugly fat hogs out here.
But I'm going to tell you what, just as sure as you're going to have any kind of tournament, any kind at all, Bruno, somebody in the stable is going to be the one giving away that coat. You figure right now, if I open up in that thing with Jerry Stubbs, you won't be giving away no coat, and any gal puts her name in your box will be wasting her time. It'll be the same thing a man against Brian Lee. You'll have the same problem the man against Jimmy Golden, and the same problem the man that wrestles Cactus Jack, Daddy, that we're winners, and we're going to prove it. Me, Coat, Cages, or anything else. We gone.
The words of the one and only Tennessee stud, Robert Fuller, and a little irate about some Sylvia not eligible for the coat tournament. I mean, doesn't take an Einstein to figure that out, J.R. We've got exciting news right now we'd like to share with the folks down around Mobile, Alabama.
That's
our
right.
Good friends around Ball and Mobile counties. Pensacola, the CWF,
be on tour in that area of the country. We're proud to be back in that part of the country. We've got some interesting dates coming up in that area.
That's right, Charlie. The big Southern tour. We're going to start out right there in Foley, Alabama, Charlie, on Thursday night at the National Guard Armory. A lot of big matches. The Lethal Weapon will be there defending his belt against Jerry Stubbs that night. We go on the next night to Crestview, Florida, Thursday night, November the 16th, Charlie. Big night there. We got a big six-man challenge match that night.
And then in Pensacola, Florida, we'll be there Sunday the 19th at the National Guard Armory. Is that right?
That's right. That's on 1300 West Gregory Street, Charlie, downtown. Nice big building there. We're going to be coming in there on a regular basis to Pensacola, so be on the lookout for us there in Pensacola.
Big Thunderdome Battle Royal down there.
$5,000, Charlie, that night. $5,000 Thunderdome Battle Royal right there in Pensacola. And then we're going on for Thanksgiving night to Mobile, Alabama.
Old location, old face with a new face. Fort Whiting.
Fort Whiting National Guard Armory. A big building, great building for wrestling, and we're looking forward to going there. And that night's going to be the big mink coat tournament, Charlie.
All right, thank you, Johnny Rich. We're looking forward to the big Southern Swing down around Mobile, Alabama, Pensacola, and all those areas. Make your plans to come out and enjoy the very finest in professional wrestling with the Continental Wrestling Federation. Coming out to join me for just a moment, Mr. Perfect, Jerry Stubbs, and anytime you appear when Robert Fuller's in the arena, he gets a little nervous.
You know, really, Charlie, it's got to be a joke, you know. A couple of shows I was supposed to make, you know, and I went to get my car fixed. You know, it broke down on me. I went to get it fixed, and the man says, you know, somebody's been messing with your car. I said, oh, yeah, well, I know who that somebody is. Well, you know, I don't like being out here on the road. Something happened to me, killed me. I sure would be awful mad, you know. And Robert Fuller, I know who's behind it, and I'm going to take it out on you. Even if you didn't do it, I'm going to take it out on you.
That's a good one.
Two things, Charlie, while I'm out here. Let me mention two things. The mink coat tournament is coming up. Well, Robert Fuller, you got me first round. First time up, boys. So don't, hey, if any of you got any intentions of putting your name in Robert Fuller's box, don't do it, because he's not going to make it. I can tell you that right now. And if I don't get him there, I'm going to get him in the cage matches. He can't go. And I know he don't want to get in there with all that fence around me. Because I'm going to break his neck, Charlie. I can plan it.
Words of Mr. Perfect, Jerry Stubbs, and the Southern Boys of Mixie Dynamite will be in the steel cage match. We'll be back with more great wrestling action. Coming up, our television main event, Dennis Condrey against Brad Armstrong when the CWF continues. By our director, Mickey, that there's some part of a party going on in the back dressing room that it's unfortunately having to do with the stud stable. Let's go back and we've got a camera back there. See what's going on right now.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Bruno. Happy birthday to you.
That's it, Bruno. Happy day for you.
Wonderful.
And it's a happy day for wrestling because, you know, wrestling celebrates every year on Bruno's birthday. And there's no better time to do our celebrating than right now and right here. Live, Bruno. Blow it out for all the people in CWF, all your friends out there. Let's get it, Bruno.
Yeah.
Perfect. Perfect.
Every day you turn 21.
No, it's not every day you turn 21, Bruno. You know, we're very proud of you here in the stable. And you know, all the guys got together earlier this week.
Yeah, guys.
Let me get around to Bruno's gift. That we got together earlier this week and trying to decide what we'd get Bruno. And over and over again, we just toiled and toiled. We couldn't come up with anything. And then it fell right into our hands. Today it happened. Today, Bruno, I wound up with what I feel like is one of the greatest pieces of material that's ever come down the pike in this business. Looking right behind you right there, you see our man, Brickhouse Brown, the newest addition to the stable, Bruno. Hold my cigar there, sweetheart.
Like a good boy to me.
There's your contract.
Thank you.
There's your man.
All right.
How about it? This is the day CWF is going to remember for a long time because my man... Yeah.
You never said nothing to me, man, by transferring me over to Bruno. I made the deal with you.
No, well, what you probably don't realize, Brick, is in the company here and all the guys are back up...
I don't realize anything but one thing. I signed with you. What's up with Bruno, man? I don't know nothing about
Bruno. Bruno is the manager of our stable. Bruno runs our business
He's
out
the
there.
Man.
You're going to be learning a lot of things as you work in this stable, but one thing you'll have to realize right now is just like Brian Lee and myself, Cactus Jack Manson, Jimmy Golden, we all, in a sense, belong to Bruno, and I guess you'll just have to fall right in there, too. But you know, you're standing there looking at me kind of funny. You know, I'm kind of wondering, we get into these meat coat tournaments, am I going to be having any trouble with you? And I want to tell you something. If I wind up wrestling with you, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to do it for Bruno and do it for everybody. I want you to win, Brickhouse Bell.
I like it.
I like it. Hey, first of all, I didn't get into wrestling to turn the other cheek. And if there's any kind of tournament around anywhere and I'm entered in it, I ain't got no intentions but to win it.
Well, here we go. That's what we want to hear.
Happy birthday, Bruno.
Well, thank you.
Now entering the ring from Muscle Shoals, Alabama, the Continental Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, the Lethal Weapon, Dennis Condrey. Here's a photo from Marietta, Georgia, Brad Armstrong. Hey, no intro. Let's have a little fight here. That's what it looks like. Brad Armstrong comes in, and a ball of fire. Good shot to the midsection, coming off of the ropes. A lot. Whoa. Condrey looking for the exit sign. High hip toss by Brad Armstrong. The jacket comes off. Armstrong's ready for action against the CWF heavyweight champion. And I don't know if Condrey is ready for the same action or not. It appears to me Condrey a bit reluctant about getting in the ring with Brad Armstrong. These two have a little score to settle with each other. Side headlock by Dennis Condrey, the CWF heavyweight champion. Brad throws him into the ropes. Good shoulder smash by Condrey. Coming off, up and over his man. Up and over his man goes Brad Armstrong. Flying high again with a drop kick takedown. What a match. And he wants Condrey bad. Brad Armstrong. Condrey again, that exit sign looking more and more inviting to him, I believe, as he starts back to the dressing room. However, he comes back into the ring again. Larry Brock, yeah, sure. And July the 3rd is Christmas Day. I don't think Brad Armstrong will have any part of that. Side headlock by Brad Armstrong. Good shoulder smash again by Condrey coming off the ropes. Power slam by Armstrong. From out of nowhere comes that power slam. Dennis Condrey. If we could get a shot of his face, a very frustrated looking individual at this point of the match. However, don't ever count him out. He comes back firing away hard right to Armstrong. Takes his man up. Good suplex. Well executed by the Lethal Weapon, Dennis Condrey. And this, of course, not the first meeting with Condrey. Wait a minute. Condrey out on the floor, grabs a chair. We know what would be coming up next. We know what would be coming up here. Whoa! Referee Larry Brock nailed by Condrey. And now Brad Armstrong is setting up the DDT. And he puts Condrey. He did it. Condrey goes head first into the chair. Condrey, a gash opened in his head. And now Brad Armstrong What a turnaround there. Brad Armstrong got him with the DDT on the iron part of that chair. Condrey now finds himself in a very precarious situation. Goes back into the throat of Brad Armstrong. The lethal weapon now. All right, right to the midsection. Wait a minute, he's setting his man up. Going for the DDT. And now it's Armstrong catching the DDT. Oh, I tell you. Oh, what a gash that has been opened in the head of Brad Armstrong. Oh, my gosh. This is terrible. Brad Armstrong caught the edge of that chair sticking up that you can see. We're calling it a disqualification, of course. Larry Brock was nailed in that whole thing. He was out for a time. But we have Brad Armstrong, who obviously needs some attention here. Disqualification. Oh, man, I tell you what. It looked like Brad Armstrong had things going his way for moments when he reversed the situation and put the DDT on Dennis Condrey. Condrey then turns the chair over. You see that edge of the chair. If we could get a shot of that, obviously, is what caught the head of Brad Armstrong. It was sticking up, and boy, it has really put a gash in him that will... We need to get him out of here. There is a pool of blood in the middle of the ring. What a shot he took on that chair. We're going to take a break. We're going to take a break right here, and we'll be back with more on the Continental Wrestling Federation in a matter of moments. It ends in a disqualification.
Look out, Mobile. Here comes the Continental Wrestling Federation Thursday night, November 23rd at 7:30 in Fort Whiting Armory. Don't miss it. It's the Mink Coat Tournament for Mobile. In the first round, Dennis Condrey meets Brickhouse Brown. Robert Fuller with Sylvia takes on Jerry Stubbs. Jimmy Golden with Bruno takes on Steve Armstrong. Brian Lee meets Tracy Smothers. Mark the Beast Goulin with Sylvia takes on Adrian Street with Linda. Jack Manson with Bruno takes on Dixie Dynamite. And Ron Starr takes on Todd Morton. All that in the first round of the Mink Coat Tournament. 11 big matches. One lucky lady is walking out of Fort Whiting Armory with a brand new, beautiful, expensive mink coat. Absolutely free. All you got to do is pick the right wrestler. Thursday night, November 23rd at 7:30. It's the Continental Wrestling Federation in Mobile. Don't miss it.
Well, they're still trying to get Brad Armstrong out of the back now, and the lethal weapon, Dennis Condrey, has joined us here at ringside, and certainly you had the tables turned on you, but you got the best when it was over.
Let me tell you something, Charlie Platt. I don't care nothing about no meat coat tournament. I don't care nothing about no Thunderdome. All I care is what I'm doing right now, and I'm having me a Mealy Massacre, baby. That's what I like. I like blood and guts. I like to fight. I like to go for it. Let me tell you something. I'm just like a famous gunslinger. I got a bunch of young punks gunning for me, and so far, every one of them ended up in Boot Hill. Look at Jerry Stubbs. Look at Danny Davis. Wendell Cooley. Kerry Von Erich. Dr. Tom Pritchard. The list goes on and on and on. And now, I got another young punk to my credit, baby, by the name of Brad Armstrong. Let me tell you something, buddy. You don't know this hole right in here. You don't know the DDT, Brad Armstrong. You don't know it at all. You don't know how bad it can hurt somebody. You're just learning it. I perfected the hold. I got it patented. It's mine. Leave it alone. Don't never try that with me again, buddy, or I'll put you out for good. I've already put Brother Bob out. I'm going to put you out, Brad. I'm going to put Stevie out. And I'm going to put that Cape Crusader out before it's all over.
Well, like it or not, and a lot of folks I'm sure don't, there's a lot of truth in what the man says. He is the lethal weapon in his country. We'll be back with more in just a moment. Right now, let's see what's happening in your local arena.
The Continental Wrestling Federation is on tour and coming to your area with all the big names and big stars and big wrestlers. Look out, Foley, Alabama. Wednesday night, November 15th is your night, 7:30, and the National Guard Armory. Don't miss it. Crestview, Florida will never leave you out. Thursday night, November 16th at 7:30 in the National Guard Armory, and in Pensacola. Sunday night, November 19th at 7:30 in the National Guard Armory. Pensacola, you get the $5,000 Thunderdome Battle Royal. Don't miss it. Plus, a Continental Tag Match. As Jimmy Golden and Brian Lee take on the Southern Boys, Tracy Smothers and Steve Armstrong. And for the Continental title, Loverboy Dennis Condrey meets Brad Armstrong in a battle for the belt. And in a special challenge match, Robert Fuller with Sylvia meets Jerry Stubbs to try to settle that difference. And lots more in Pensacola, Sunday night, November 19th at 7:30 in the National Guard Armory. Don't miss the excitement of a CWF.
Well, we've certainly seen a lot of great action that ended up, I don't know how to describe that last one. I tell you what, Brad Armstrong's head brought into the edge of that chair, the piece of the metal was sticking up from the back of that chair, and he has
heavily lacerated on the head there.
We have, in the closing moments of the program, I'd like to remind you that coming up, there'll be eight men in the steel cage, and a lot to be settled in that situation.
That's right, Charlie. That's going to be a big match in itself. I just want to remind the people down in the Florida area that wrestling will not be on next Saturday. We will be preempted. But don't forget, wrestling will be right there in Pensacola Sunday night. And in Thanksgiving night, we'll be right there at Fort Whiting National Guard Armory for the big mink coat tournament.
Be good to see all the folks down around Mobile and Pensacola again. And I'd like to remind you, those mink coat tournaments coming up. Boy, what a night. It's going to be 17 of them in all, right? Wait a minute. Brad Armstrong is... Boy, you need...
I don't want to interrupt anything here, but I want to direct something to you, Dennis Condrey. No, you're right, I don't know the DDT all that well, but I knew it just well enough, brother, to drop your head on that chair and to bust your head wide open. Yeah, I don't look too good right now, and this may be the face of a loser, but boy, I don't doubt it, because I'm standing tall, and I've proved one thing, not to you, I've proved to all of these good people all around the continental area, and I proved it in the Armstrong name, brother, that continuously, time after time, the Armstrongs can take a licking, brother, and keep on ticking. Yeah! And Dennis Condrey, I know you're coming down to my neck of the woods, brother. Pensacola, Florida's on November the 19th, and I've got it circled on my calendar, Jack, because you and me are going head-to-head, and it's time for a little revenge. Armstrong style, Southern-born, Southern-bred, brother. In Pensacola, you may be Southern-dead.
I think that pretty much says it all. Boy, he is.
That's right. Be sure and tune in next week, Charlie. Just tell them all, be sure to tune in next week for a big, exciting card next week.
Well, we got a lot of great action coming your way next week on the Continental Wrestling Federation. For Johnny Rich, Charlie Platt saying so long from Montgomery.